But then you have those that are fishing for commercial purposes. You have those that are fishing for a livelihood. What is being done to educate that section of the population, proper practices, proper procedures, and to empower them to know that it's a balance. We all have to live off this ecosystem.
So we don't have anything in particular being done right now in terms of educating the fishermen, but since we have as a stranding network, it's one of our goals to get out there and really let people know that we all need to work together, and our fishermen really are our eyes out there. And many of the strandings that we have responded to, the fishermen have played a tremendous role in us being able to actually make a positive response. We use their boats, they help us, go out there and monitor the coastline. So as a network, it's something that we are trying to promote, and we're going to try to get some more educational activities out there. We've gone on actually gone out to some of the schools, because you know sometimes they show the movies in IMAX.
Yes, and
show
exactly. Things, right?
So we've been there, we've taken samples, we've taken specimens out, talking to the kids, you know, so whenever an opportunity presents itself, we do certainly make use of it.
Yes. So that's three things. There's the ministry and the training is going on. I want to encourage that. Lots of NGOs, friends and fishermen of the sea, stranding groups like us, NGOs going into marine mammal conservation. And then you also have corporate sponsors trying to get them involved too.
You spoke about the parasite in terms of that particular type of fish. Are we doing research to see what's causing it and how will we stop it?
Yeah, at the University of the School of Veterinary Medicine, that's where I'm based, we do have the aquatic animal health unit, and all animals that strand, if they either die or for whatever reason, or you know, we end up having to put them down, they are all examined thoroughly. So all samples are completely examined, so we're starting to get a picture now of what are the, you know, the main infectious and some non-infectious causes of strandings in Trinidad and Tobago, yes.
So as we wrap this interview, I know before I close this interview, we're gonna show that entire clip again because the footage is amazing. I don't know if I would ever jump into the oceans. We're gonna show that whole video from the beginning to the end because it really is, I think they just kind of dramatized the entire encounter. That's really closing comments, and this is really about the excitement surrounding the fact that this is such, that we've never had footage like this make its way out in the public domain. But people are now going to get a little more curious. The adventure seekers will try to duplicate, replicate, and top that. And that's just human nature. What do you want to say to people out there?
It's beautiful footage. These are beautiful creatures. When we see them, it just elicits awe. And the fact that they're actually in our waters and they're coming, they're visiting us, it evokes in us also a respect for them, a very healthy respect. And we want to learn as much as we can and just be safe and be respectful.
Be safe and be respectful, and I'm going to ask our directors and our producers to start the video from the very beginning, because I mean, when I saw it, I was literally taken aback because we've never seen footage like this. And while it's all the hype, apparently the orca has been here for quite a while now. So let's share that with you as we go to the next break.
Right, I'm trying to get simple department when they were done, and won't see them again. But there is one male that was pretty inquisitive, and he kept breaking away from the pod, and he would come and say, "Go reward," and say, "Go reward," and go, and then he would keep coming back, and he came back a few times, and then I thought maybe a good idea for me to jump in and try to get this whale underwater, try to get a video of this whale. So he decided to come back towards the boat again, and I was like, "All right, this is it, and jump off the back of the boat." Just how do you do this huge hand, this up here, and I just swim straight up to me. I guess I was a bit in shock. I think maybe like 5 feet right in front of me before you sink. Alright, for change, I don't know what was gonna happen. I'm not sure. Maybe it is that for me, but realized that he was a male now, with his red kind of arm, he just kind of looking at me and checking me out, and he's kind of interested. Same way out, I was interested in looking at him, same way for him, I guess, that he just kind of turned and just kind of looked up at me, and he just stood right behind the boat that just passed right next to me, and that was it. Tobago, and get a chance to capture a few guys.